W-O-R-D, we're coming up. Keep it coming up. So do your dance quick, mama. Come on, baby, tell me what's the word. Your brother, your sister, and your mom too, 'cause they're about to throw down, and you know just what to do. Wave your hands in the air like you don't care. Fly by the people as they start to look and say, Do your dance wake them up. Keep it coming up. So do your dance quick, mama. Come on, baby, tell me what's the word.
Going to be doing a little show for you. Obviously, it's going to be different than how it normally is, but we're just making the best of it. It's going to be super fun. This will be our last show of the semester. Things will probably go wrong. My computer's volume blasts super randomly, so I hope that happens, because that would be startling. That would be so startling. It's just a fun, sexy time. So this is just gonna be really crazy, really fun, really great. Why don't we all get into it right now?
Woo! Yes, yeah. Love it.
Well, John, yeah. You're gonna be hosting this one, so why don't you take it away?
Yeah. Okay. So meeting adjourned. We are gathered in this certain town. What town are we gathered in, everyone?
What game are we playing? Yeah, what game are we playing?
All right. Zoom take two.
Meeting adjourned.
Hey, everyone.
Game over. Adjourned.
We're going to be playing a game called Town Hall Meeting. Now that we know what game we're playing, what is the name of this town?
San Francisco.
Does it matter, Ville?
The name of the town doesn't matter. The teams are going to be Nigel, Taylor, Aaron, Hannah, Ryan, and Annabelle on one side. Did you guys all get that? Do you need me to say it again?
Yes, say it again.
Okay, one more time. It's Nigel, Taylor, Aaron, Hannah, Ryan, and Annabelle. They're on one side. The other team, Brayden, Eric, Christian, Keaton, and Allie. Okay? Yes.
Amazing.
So we all got it. Great.
Amazing.
Now that we've got the sides, let's go with what are they fighting about? What are they debating about? Give me two suggestions.
Umbrella or rain jacket?
Okay, not bad.
Tortilla versus burrito bowl.
Oh, shoelaces burrito. Versus Velcro.
Burrito, not bad. Taco.
Apple Music or Spotify?
Ooh. I honestly like
homicide versus. Just kidding.
Umbrella versus rain jacket. I like that one. That's good shit. So, team Nigel, Hannah, Taylor, Ryan, Aaron, Annabelle, you guys are going to be umbrella. Other team is going to be rain jacket. Okay. I'm going to run in.
Wait, what side are we again?
Umbrella, Hannah.
Thank you. I'm going to run in. Hey, welcome everyone to this town. Woo! So today, if you didn't know, we're debating something kind of cray-cray. It's kind of out there, okay? And it's umbrellas or rain jackets. So, let's open it up. Does anyone have anything they want to say? Yes, sir, you.
Hi, I'm Natasha Bedingfield, and personally, I like rain jackets more because there's a better opportunity to feel the rain on your skin. Given by my hit song, Unwritten. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Natasha. Does anyone have a rebuttal of sorts to that sort of thing? Yes, ma'am, you with the glasses.
Hi, my name is Sarah. I am 14 and I am hydrophobic. So feeling the rain on my skin is literally my worst nightmare. When my mom forces me to go out when it's raining, because she says that my therapist says I need to face my fears, and I don't really want to face my fears, but my mom makes me sometimes, so I always have the largest size umbrella with me. It's got an arm span larger than this. It's about 10 feet across, 10 feet this way. So, got to keep it covered. So umbrellas.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much, Sarah. Yes, sir. Yeah. You over here.
Hey, my name's Jack Edison, Jack Ed for short. And I just need to let you in on a little time when my wife and I we're trying something a little crazy in the bedroom. And, you know, we didn't have anything but a shampoo bottle and an umbrella. And let's just say many medical bills later, we finally got it out down below, if you know what I'm saying. So we steer clear of umbrellas in this house.
We hear you loud and clear, Jackhead. Yes, you in the yellow over there.
Hi, my name's Rachel. I go to TCU. I'm a junior. But first and foremost, I'm a frog camp counselor. It did it, didn't it? I'm also a surface owner, proud surface owner. This is not endorsed. I'm first of all worried. I can't tell if it's still happening. And because of your faces, so.
Thank you so much. All right, moving on. Anyone else? Yes, sir, you with the ginger beard.
Yes, my name is Scott Carlisle, and my family has been hunting witches for generations. What are we? Oh, about umbrellas. First thing, they take up at least one hand to use. Rain jacket, flowing to fight and combat all the witches. Second thing, who uses umbrellas? I don't know. Hagrid from Harry Potter. Mary Poppins. Other such magical creatures that need to be destroyed by the Carlisle witch hunting family. Down with umbrellas, rain jackets. For us non-magic folk.
Thank you very much, Mr. Carlisle. That was something. Yes, ma'am, you down there in the white t-shirt.
It's Rihanna. I just wanted to say, Natasha Bedingfield, you can go suck a fat one. you should feel the rain on your skin. Or you could try a motherfucking umbrella. I don't know. Listen to music. Try it out. I'm a savage. X by Fenty. It's my new lingerie line. Thank you.
Wow.
Bye bye.
Thank you very much. Natasha, what do you have to say back to that?
I'm only going to say kind things, Rihanna, because I have a pocket full of sunshine. And I only offer kind words. Maybe you should try a raincoat one day to cover up your nudity.
Oh, order, order, order. I will get this meeting back adjourned now. Order. My goodness. Yes, sir. You with the green band tie.
Hi, hello there. My name is Gene Kelly. You may recognize me from my lead role in Singing in the Rain. I did not just Google. I knew that the whole time. And let me tell you, my friend down there with the ginger beard that is afraid of people with umbrella being magic, well, when you're up on that stage and you're singing in the rain, you're magic too.
Yes.
That's all I got to say.
Thank you very much, Gene Kelly. Thank you very much, Gene Kelly. Yes, ma'am. You down there in the corner with the tie on your head.
I'm not a bee. I'm not a wasp. I'm a yellow jacket. And the only other kind of acceptable jacket is a rain jacket.
Yes. Well, thank you very much, yellow jacket. Yes, sir. You down there with your hand. Yes, you.
Hey, my name is Josh Radner. I played Ted on How I Met Your Mother. You know, this show, that's me right there. You may not have seen me in much else, but you can definitely see me here holding my yellow umbrella. And that's how I met my wife in the show I'm really passionate about. The only show I've ever been in, except for like two other shows that nobody watched, okay? So please, please, umbrella, please, please.
Thank you so much, Josh. Yes, sir, you with the medallion.
Yeah, hi, my name is Patricia. I'm the Morton Salt girl, and I'm just telling you, it's so much better in that yellow jacket than it is with an umbrella, because jackets, not only do they keep you dry, they also keep you warm.
That's a very good point. That's a very good point. Yes, sir, you with the hat.
Yeah, so the hat is actually really covering a really bad injury that I had, and I actually was wondering if the sir with the ginger beard, I think I heard that you were fighting magic. I don't know what's happening.
I have the witches.
There's some man, and there's like rain, and there's like meatballs falling from the sky, and it's a really bad storm. And I don't know, but I got hit in the head, and honestly, the only thing that kept me safe was an umbrella, and that's the only thing that gave me protection. So do what you want, say what you want, hear what you want, but all I know is the umbrella kept me safe. But if you have some other alternative, tell me.
Order, order. Tell me. Carlisle, you may respond.
Yes. When you look at the word umbrella, its history is from the Latin umbra, bella, meaning little, and shadow. Now, what else do we know about Latin? It is used by the witches for hexes and curses. And that is where the evil food rain has come from and harmed your head, sir. You have been cursed by the evil magical umbrella witches.
Order! Order! There will be no curses. Order, Mr. Carlisle. We have time for perhaps one more. Yes, Mrs. You, yellow.
I'd like to give this one more go, because I don't think my point came across at all when I first spoke, because I was so scared about my computer. I'm a frog camp counselor, and something I like to do on buses is play, like, you know, games. And one game is the umbrella game, where you have to say something about whether or not, like, and I'll tell you if it works, and only an umbrella works. Does anyone know the game I'm talking about?
No, we don't.
Three last door?
No, it's like, okay, like, I'm bringing an umbrella, and if you don't know what to bring on the picnic, you can always take an umbrella.
Does anyone have any other thoughts? Yes, Natasha, you, yes.
Yeah, I just want to be straight up. Based on that last argument, I think we should win right now. That's all.
Hey, come on. Hey.
All right. Order.
You are rude, girl. Give it up.
Order, Rihanna. Order. I will now, because my audience is rather biased, I will be conducting the decision myself. The brain has churned, and I have decided that you guys are right based on that last comment. Rain jacket wins.
Yeah.
You fought hard, Umbrella. You fought hard.
Guys, I am so insecure about
incredible.
Every time I watch y'all's reactions, I cannot tell if my computer is blasting, and I am so insecure. I think I'm just gonna switch to my phone. Because
no, Hannah, you'll know when it happens because we'll all jump backwards.
Yeah.
It adds a nice surprise element. Don't dare switch.
Also, you spent more time talking about how afraid that you were of it, giving it more time to do it rather than just getting your answer out and getting back out.
Because it would happen. I think it happened, but I don't know if it happened because you guys would go.
That's because of how you were talking.
Waiting for you to get on with it.
That's because. Okay.
Here's the
next game.
Oh right, it's me. I'm on the next game. And this game is called Town Hall Meeting. No, that's the game we just.
Oh my gosh.
What a flawless execution. We're an oiled machine.
We are out of practice.
Less than perfection.
All right, this game is called Press Conference, and it's for all of us, but specifically John. John is going to be guessing. He's going to have to, he's an inventor, right? And he invented something somewhere with someone important. And he has to guess what those are based on the questions that we as, like, you know, reporters and whatever ask him. And so
wait,
John,
say one more time.
What, where, who?
Who you invented it with.
I have an acronym. What, where, who?
AirPods
think of
now.
the vowels.
John, we can, like, wave to you when you're ready, right?
Okay, so mute your computer.
Let me put my AirPods in. Let me not mute my computer. I'm just gonna put my AirPods in.
Yeah.
Dumb.
Well, I'm just gonna assume he can't hear us now.
Okay. All right, so what did he invent? What product did he invent?
Dorita.
Plunger. A ShamWow.
Oh, Flex Seal.
AirPods.
The Squidward. The Slap Chop.
Slap Chop.
I heard Doritos.
Get out of my
Wait. Zoom.
Doritos.
No. Doritos. Let's do Doritos. Where did he invent it?
Zoom.
The Galapagos. Zoom. The Galapagos
Zoom.
Island.
Zoom.
The Bean in Chicago.
Wherever.
Look at John.
Yellowstone National Park.
The Bean in Chicago.
The Bean in Chicago.
Right.
And who did he invent it with?
Bruno Mars.
Oh, Quentin Tarantino.
Ginger Snap.
Ginger Snap.
Wait, no. He doesn't know. Seth Rogen.
Oh, he doesn't know Ginger Snap.
Yeah, John doesn't even understand Ginger Snap. He never showed
right. For anyone watching this who doesn't understand, Ginger Snap is a running joke on Stack. We always have a pet who is named Ginger Snap. And John probably wouldn't know that, so we won't. we'll do. Let's do Quentin Tarantino.
Okay, cool.
All right, so to recap, it is Doritos with Quentin Tarantino.
Good. Nobody better show their feet.
Dorito being Tarantino.
Great.
Yep.
Cool.
I never waved it down.
Jesus.
Hold on.
He mouthed
home. Okay.
Yeah, like we couldn't hear you.
Okay, I'm back.
Welcome back.
Hello, everyone. It's so good to see you all there.
Yes, I invented this thing. Yes, I did. And do we have any questions about this awesome thing that I invented? Yes, you in the yellow.
Hey, my name is Todd Werner, and I'm the head of advertising for the Super Bowl, just like in general. And I just gotta say, thank you. You've brought in an entirely new audience. Kept it going. So.
You're so welcome. I did do that. Thank you. Yes. Any other questions? Yes, ma'am. Are you in the attire on your head? Yes.
Yes, thank you. Well, I just wanted to say I so appreciate I'm your local geometry teacher for third graders, and I'd just like to say I'm so over squares, so over circles. So glad you picked the third underrated one for publicizing your thing. Oh, thank you.
Yes. Thank you for that token. Yes. You with the medallion necklace.
What's up, dude? My name is Bon Jadar, and I just want to say thank you so much. When it's like 3 a.m. and I'm feeling like, you know, I'm feeling, I love to go get these tacos. This is like best thing ever. Thank you so much for this product.
Yes, I did invent Taco Bell. No, not even the same. Ah, yes, you in the blue shirt.
Hey, I'm Paris Hilton. I actually don't really care about your product, but I wanted to let you guys know that I just bought some new property. I think we might turn it into a really cool ranch.
Yes. Oh! Yes, I did indeed invent Doritos Cool Ranch.
Just
tacos.
Simple.
More general, man.
Doritos. I invented Doritos.
Yeah.
Yes, I got it right. Yes. Whoa. All right. Oh, I'm sweating. All right. Yes. Any other questions? Yes, sir. You with your yes.
You're gonna have to be more specific there, bud.
The one that just said you're gonna have to be more specific there, bud.
Cool. Hey there. Name's Jimbo Cuckleberry. I here work for this great company. They got a little logo of a dog, and they like to sell this vegetable in a can. It's great at cookouts and things like that. You like to bake them, all sorts of things. It's quite delicious. But anyways, just the location in which you made your thing. I lost my train of thought thinking about those delicious vegetables in a can. Sorry about that.
Yes, thank you so much. Any other? Yes, you down there in the white shirt with your hand.
Hello, hi, hello. My name is Lima. You may know my brother Baked or Pinto. We are so grateful for the publicity you've given our family. It's just, you know, we're the little guys. People just look over us. And of course, our big brother. Our big brother gets all the attention. He gets all the photo ops. He gets all the landmarks and whatnot. But again, from me, Lima, and my brothers, Pinto and Baked.
Yes, when I invented the Doritos at the Chicago Bean.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
What a time that was. You're so welcome for putting the beans on the map. Yes, I do try.
Thank you.
Yes, sir, you in the baseball hat.
Yeah, one second. Honey! I know! You're the greatest! I know! Goodbye! Sorry. It's Samuel, as always. You know I love to stop at these things. I just had one question for you, sir. Is how in the world did you manage to get him to help you with this? I tried for so long to get his attention, and I just can't! It's like, my man, we are on a schedule! Do you not listen? I don't know. He just does whatever he wants nowadays, but that's okay. He's making money, and that's just okay. That's all I have to say. Just amazing, amazing work. Truly. Goodbye, honey.
You actually cut out. What was your name?
My name is just Samuel. Some people call me Sam. Samuel Jackson.
Yeah, yes, yes. Good, 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 good. Oh, thank you very much, Samuel. Yes, sir. You with the beard down there?
Yeah, the name's William. It's long for things. And I just want to say I'm terrified that your partner might murder me in some fashion, probably violently with a sword. I'm not sure why. I can think of probably 8 reasons. He's just a hateful person. And I don't approve.
Yes, very good. 8 is important somehow. Yes, sir. You in the maroon.
Hello there. It's me, Margot Robbie. And I just wanted to know, mate, why did you choose him? You know, I think that, you know, Doritos have become such a man thing, and that your partner doesn't really like women. That's why it's become a man thing. So, yeah, do you hate women also, I guess is my question.
I can't believe I made it with Mel Gibson.
I wish you made it with Mel Gibson, but you didn't.
That was when we made Lay's, my mistake. Yes, you in the, you down there with the hand in the wristbands, you with the wristbands.
Hey, it's Brad Pitt. First of all, I just want you to tell your partner I'm sorry about fucking up that Italian accent in that one movie we did together, Gorlami. the other one, I want you to thank him for making me such a badass. Yeah.
Sorry.
Yes, when I invented this with Leonardo DiCaprio. My goodness, yes, Mrs. You in the Yellow.
You know, yeah, it's me. Okay.
You, sir, yes, sorry.
My yeah, I really just gotta say, you know, this guy, I've got a great story, you know, once upon a time with this guy. It was so great. And this man, he's the big kahuna, you know? He's a huge, huge, big, big guy. You know, like really likes to... He can pound people, like pound the pulp out of them. It's not fake, you know? It's,
yes, sir, yes, yes. When I invented this with Quentin Tarantino, it was, quite a joy. So, yes. Well, thank you all for coming to my meeting where we discussed that I invented Doritos at a...
Not the first thing, man.
What is my brother's?
There are 2 planes.
Oh, at the Chicago Bean.
The St. Louis Bean.
St. Louis Bean. With Quentin Tarantino, mother.
Yeah.
Nice and short. Amazing.
To the point. Love it.
All right. So our next game we have for everyone is called Good, Bad, Worst. And this game is for Allie, Hannah, and Eric. So the way this game works is that we're going to get some good advice, some bad advice, and some worst advice. And you, as the audience, are going to be asking some questions. And I have a few here that some were sent in, and then I might ask our audience here on the Zoom call. Yeah. But yeah, Hannah's gonna, you know, or Allie's gonna be our good advice, Hannah's gonna be our bad, and Eric's gonna be our worst. So I'll have Allie introduce herself real quick.
Hello, sweet laddies. It's me, Mrs. Claus. You might know my husband pretty well. Well, I am in charge of the nice list, so I thought I'd come and give you some advice of how you can get on there yourself. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, Mrs. Claus. You in the yellow.
I'm Daniel. I'm a freshman. I live in Clark. Sorry, I just smoked weed for the first time with my roommate Ronnie. Sorry, I thought that was my RA. Okay.
Thank you, Daniel. And you in the red beard.
Yeah. My name's Tony. It's short for Tony. I'm the world's first ballerino. It's like a ballerina, but masculine, because I'm a dude. That's what I do. I wanted to do things. My mom made me take dance classes. I said, I'm going to do it, but I'm going to do it big and hard.
Thank you, Tony. All right, so our first question here comes from Chris Herrero. And she says, how to be funny, Mrs. Claus.
Chris, you invented funny. You've been on the nice list for funny for years. So kind of you to be so humbled to ask. You're fabulous.
Thank you, Mrs. Claus. And Daniel, Dan, say, hey, how to be funny.
I don't know, just like make fun of people's insecurities.
Yeah, and thank you, Daniel. And Tony.
First things first, if you want me to be a part of this, I'm not wearing a tutu. I drew that line in sixth grade and I never looked back. Second things first, I'm not gonna ask questions, answer questions that I don't ask, okay? I hope you understand that. When I was a kid, if you played drink, I broke bows. And you don't understand that, frankly, you shouldn't be asking any questions because I know more than you, I'm a ballerino.
Thank you, Tony. All right, let's get a question from our Zoom audience, actually. Anybody have any questions? Yeah, you in the white shirt.
Hey, it's Jess. I'm a Delta Nu. I was wondering, like, in my speech class, if I don't, like, practice the speech or whatever, what is the best way to handle that? Like, should I freeze on the camera? Or, like, should I act like my dog just, like, got hit by a car? Or, like, what's your best excuse to get out of Zoom class? Because, like, they can't even clock you, you know?
Great question, Jess. Take it away, Mrs. Claus.
Well, Jess, I know you very well.
Oh, that's funny.
I like to say, well, whenever I have to get out of things with my husband, if you know what I'm saying, I just make him a little batch of cookies and he goes right to sleep.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Thank you, Mrs. Claus. Daniel.
Sorry, I heard that your teachers, like, can track you, so, like, if you have class and you, like, don't go, then they, like, know what you're doing on your computer because your like, camera, they, like, see your camera, because you've used Zoom before, so they, like, have your account, they have your IP address, they have everything, so it's, like, yeah. It's, like, you can't.
Ew.
You have to go to class.
Thank you, Daniel. Tony.
Yeah, never mind. First things first, interior design. I've replaced all the ceilings and windows in my room with mirrors. I want to be able to see everything at all times. Next thing you want to do is you're going to wake up in the morning and take an ice bath. What will that do? Make it cold. You want to turn the heat all the way up and form clouds inside of your home. You got to precipitate, and then you're going to hesitate.
Thank you, Tony. Let's get a question from our Instagram people. Allison Wade says, how do I social distance, Mrs. Claus?
Oh, Allison. Yes, well, you know, I've been seeing what you've been doing with your friends, and that's not what you're supposed to be doing. I think you should, you know, the yardstick, you make it times three, and you distance, and you need to stop seeing the boys, dear. You need to stop seeing the boys.
Thank you, Mrs. Claus. Great things. Daniel.
Well, with so Ron, well, Ronnie and I, so Ronnie and I, we, like, you know, didn't, it's like he gave me the bong and I, like, wiped it off.
Oh, I see where you're going there. Yeah. Tony.
Yeah, so when I find a clover in a field, every time it's five leaves, it's super lucky. The only kind of salad I will eat is a Caesar salad because I was born to rule. Okay. I don't trust the banks, so I made my own. Unless, of course, it's a bank I trust.
Okay, let's get one more question from our Zoom. Yeah, you in the black.
Hi, my name is Josh Radner. We talked earlier. I played I Met Your Mother. And on that show, I was an architect. And so my question is, if you were in a room with two windows and no door, hypothetically, what would you call it?
Mrs. Claus.
Did you say two windows and no doors? I'm sorry, yes. You cut out a bit. And what do you do?
What do you call the room? What's the name of it?
Oh, yes, thank you. I'm a little hard of hearing at my age, so we have you. Yes, I would call it a door. No, not a door. There's no door. A room with two windows and no doors. That's what I'd call it. Yes.
I think Daniel's rubbing off a little bit on you, Miss. Daniel, let's take it away.
So,
oh, God.
So it's a door. It's a room. It's a room with no doors, and two I don't like thinking about this, man. Can someone else go?
The first thing that happened to me when I became the world's first ballerino was I made a lot of money. So what did I do with all that money? I made my own whey protein powder. There were many options I went with. I've decided since you mix it with water, I called it pirouette.
And that's the game. That's the game.
Oh my God.
I would like to apologize. My entire family just got home and was trying to get into the door. So see what I was doing. I was like, Dad, stop. He's like, I can't say hi. I want to be on the show. And that's what happens in every one of my Zoom classes.
Oh my God. You're strong.
Thank you. Also, my dog barks a lot, so there's also that happening.
I bark a lot, that's okay. All right, next game.
All right, that's my job. The next game is called Pen Pals, and it's for Keaton and Taylor. Woo! So for those of you that don't know how this works, is that Keaton and Taylor met at a summer camp or some other kind of camp last summer, and they are going to try to keep in touch over by being pen pals. And we will see their correspondence going back and forth and seeing how their relationship develops. So what was the name of the camp that they went to last summer?
Winnipesaukee.
Sweaty Balls. Sweaty Balls.
Schmeet. Camp packing that Schmeet.
Sweaty Betties.
I like packing that Schmeet.
No, I'm just going to take Camp Schmeet. Camp Schmeet is the name. Let's have Keaton start off.
Dear
Ballsack.
Petunia.
Pelvis.
Eggplant Parm.
Petunia.
Dear Ballsack. I am so glad that I decided to travel to Miami, Florida to come to Camp Schmeet this summer. We had such a good time when we decided to climb.
Badass.
Demi Lovato's left boob.
Like a small hill.
Demi Lovato's left boob. I just remember when you fell down and scraped your knee. Anywho, hope you're having a good time as a...
Crayola.
Professional.
Crayola. Hope you're having a good time as a Crayola. Sincerely, Winifred Fred.
Dear Winifred, it was so nice meeting you at Camp Schmeet. I just couldn't believe it when I met someone foreign. How exciting. I never thought I'd see you there. I remember when I scraped my knee. You know, as a child growing up on the Jersey Shore, I'm familiar with this experience, but I had never come from such a steep angle, you know, sliding down Demi's left boob. What an experience, what a thrill. You know, I was just thinking back to one of my favorite memories with you when we
met Miller Fillmore, the 13th president.
When we ate the glue in the arts and crafts cabin. Oh, what a rush. I've never felt such a rush before. I missed you so much. I wish that we kept in touch more. Do you think you'll be going to the spinoff camp?
Sweaty balls.
Beady boy.
It's illegal.
Balls next summer? I'm considering it. Your dearest ball sack.
My dearest ball sack. I know that you know what it's like to scrape your knee because you are on them so often. And of course, I remember when we ate all that glue. I still have the medical pills. It was so silly. And yes, I do think I will be attending the side camp because my parents need some way to get rid of me because I am...
communicating effectively.
The lost son of Bruce Springsteen.
I love crafty and horror.
Communicating effectively. And they are just so exhausted of my talents in communicating effectively. I do have to let you know, though, that I don't think we can be friends anymore because I think that you're a tad bit...
communicating effectively.
Ineffectively. Communicating.
Communicating ineffectively. And I just can't handle that. I need somebody who can communicate effectively. I hope you won't be upset. Yours truly, Winifred. Send.
Winifred. It's so upsetting to hear that we can't be friends before because I'm communicating ineffectively. I've never been told that. I always talk so much, I just thought it was always effective. But, you know, I guess seeing as this might be our last correspondence, I think that I should reveal something to you. I have a secret talent of communicating with
The dead
from World War II.
With the dead from World War II. Specifically,
my lady,
a British general who was in charge of Winston Churchill. That's his.
Oh my God. And that's the game.
The Prime Minister?
Prime Minister,
yeah. You know. Prime Minister for British. Yeah, New Jersey education.
Amazing. Next game is called Fibonacci Sequence, and it's for Ryan, Aaron, and Christian.
Oh, baby.
So this game basically works where each person will only have a limited amount of words that they can say every time they talk. Ryan, well, okay, so Aaron can only do 1 to 3 words. Christian can only do 4 to 8 words, 7 words. And then Ryan can only do anywhere from 8 to 13 words. How many words can Aaron say?
1, 2, oh.
What is kidding? That was so startling. What
happened? Did something happen?
Okay, so how many words can Aaron say?
2. 1. 2. 1. 1. 1.
How many words can Christian say?
5. 5. 5.
How many words can Ryan say?
10.
12. 12. 12.
So 1, 5, and 12. All right. And why don't we get a class that they're Zooming for?
Communicating effectively.
Preliminary tennis. Preliminary
management. Ranch management. You guys are in a group project for ranch management. Okay. Let's see it.
Dude.
Hey guys, we only have like 6 more days to finish this.
That's right. Let's hurry.
Yeah.
Look, I've done a lot of the work, and honestly, I hate.
Me too. It sucks.
Yeah.
I'm gonna need a little more effort from you guys. If we...
Castrating cows is tough.
Yeah.
I understand, but we all have to do it in order to...
Graduate. I hear you, bro. Is there a lag?
It seems like there is, because otherwise, you would be saying more.
Let's Skype another time.
What? No, guys, we have to finish this project today, or else we're...
fucked. I hear you, bro.
Look.
It seems like you're trying to say something, but your internet cuts.
What?
He's frozen. Let's go.
We have to try something, or else we're going to fail together.
Guys.
That's okay. That's amazing. So.
I've never played that before.
Our next game. What do we want to do?
That's Christian. That's you.
Oh, it's John.
It's
me. No, it's... It...
Are we still doing yearbook? Do we want to? Let's do it. Yearbook is the next game.
Yeah.
All right. So the way yearbook works is... Hey, Brayden, do we have any suggestions we can use from the audience for this?
Let me look.
Like anything that would work for a club?
The dishwasher club, bikini bottom club, backyard club, your dad's house club, dildo club, CVS club.
I want you guys to shout some out. I'm not sold on any of them yet.
Club.
Jam club.
Jam.
The warm club.
Beach
babe. The club. Physical club. We all have Amazon Echoes club.
The pub club. The
cold club.
The Amazon Prime club.
Pub club.
The billionaire club. The
Amazon
club. Okay.
Mile High club.
The blub club.
Oh. I'm going to go with, in terms of celebrating COVID times, the social distancing club. The social distance.
Yeah, someone said that.
Club. Yeah, Keaton did. All right. The only thing that matters, I'm mainly saying this for my sack peeps, I'm going to go last so that we can close it off after me, and then we'll go on into our next game. Okay. So whenever you guys are ready, we'll hit our positions. 3, 2, 1, go.
Hi, I'm Barbie. You guys might not have thought about it, but my arms always have to sit parallel from my body like this. I can't get that close to anybody, because my shoulders don't go up past here. So I'm always a little bit social distance, so it's not that big of a deal for me. Also, I can't eat food. Sometimes my elbows bend. It depends on what brand. Or model.
my name is Nikki. My physical touch, my love language is physical touch, and I'm in week 8 of social distancing, and I only live with my mother, and we don't have a good relationship, so I've been really touch-starved this entire time, and it's, honestly, it's really getting to me. So, yeah.
Yeah, what's going on, man? You know, life is good. Can't complain. I'm future, from the future. And all I gotta say is I came here because I heard that they needed some help. And so I said, why not debut the old song, you know? Mask off. Frick it. Mask off. And these losers, they don't know what's coming. So, do what you need to do. Stay safe. These guys know what's happening. Social distancing club. Life is good. So I said, get into it.
On March 14th, 2020, my county went into lockdown. I received this news on my phone, which incidentally had been super glued to my hand earlier that day. Now when I try to go to the hospital to get it removed, they tell me that it's not an emergency. I just want to be able to use my hand again. Stay home, end the quarantine, end this super glue fiasco.
Hey, I'm Tobias. You may know me from my Grindr name, MaskDomTop69. You know, I've told everyone that I run 19 miles a day, but I really watch Frozen, both movies, 3 times a day, and Elsa's a lesbian.
I'm Kevin. I ran out of toilet paper 2 weeks ago, so I was hoping I'd find a stash here somewhere. Unfortunately not. I've been using a towel the whole time. Got the worst butt rash you could ever imagine.
What up, guys? My name is Jan Jacobs. You may know me from the TV show Doomsday Preppers. I saw this corona shit coming from a mile away. Let me tell you what you need in your bug out bag in case things get bad. 1, plague mask. Now, this is one from the 16th century. It still works. Fill that nose up with some poppies, you're good to go. What else do you need? You need weapons. You need supplies. You need grenades. 1, 2, 3, that's how you survive.
Hi, I'm a senior in college, and I'm upset.
The name's Mark Dupree, and I've sort of just been living in a treehouse for about 3 months now. I know what you're thinking. That's before social distancing. I'm a treehouse fanatic, okay? I love all kinds of treehouses. Oak, elm, pine, eastern hemlock. I don't discriminate. So the social distancing has not affected my life at all. So I'm kind of here to guide everyone else through it. That's why they brought me into the club, because I'm an expert in social distancing. Because after all, what is a society? People? That's just trees together, man. That's just trees together.
Hey guys, it's Kevin here. I've been in VR for about 16 months now. I'm the self-proclaimed expert at socializing from a distance. I have not left VR in about 6 weeks now. I have left my house in even longer. But yeah, no, it's great. A lot of people are talking about, like, I don't know, something about, like, Corona and how, like, the beer is doing really well, like, it's spreading all over. And, like, I don't know, I'm not really a beer guy, but hey, like, good for you guys.
Hey, I'm Mark Dupree's treehouse, and I'm fucking tired of his bullshit.
Hey there, howdy ho there, Randy. So little disclaimer, I thought it was the social discussing club. So your neighborhood discus thrower over here, Randy. Oh yeah, throwing them all the time. The furthest I can throw a discus is about a half a football field's length, which many people have told me is not that impressive. So, you know, just the social discusing master here, and people do get uncomfortable when I try and touch them. And that's our show.
Not our show, but amazing.
That's the game.
It's the show.
Oh my god.
I love that Aaron was actually on his phone. This is what I saw the whole time. His like screen flipping on his phone.
Alright. Next game is PowerPoint karaoke for Hannah and Brayden. I got it. It's ready to present.
Amazing
screen. Okay, let's get a topic for them to give this presentation on.
Beans.
10 cents.
I had some
composting.
Debbie Ryan. Sleep.
The pitch rock series.
How to fish.
Condoms. How to act at a frat party. Hostage negotiation. Best sushi.
Oh, pasta negotiation.
Like hostage negotiation.
Hostage negotiation.
Hostage negotiation.
Oh, okay. Hostage negotiation.
Pasta?
Yeah.
Hostage.
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 Pasta negotiation. It's only in, it's, we speak Italian. Yeah.
Wanted pasta. All
right. So introduce yourselves and let's see it.
Hello, my name's Barb. I am, a head of the CIA, but you don't know that. And I'm an expert on hostage negotiation, yeah.
And I'm Carb, his assistant.
Yeah, let's start, yeah, cool.
Let's start.
Okay, let's move this. Here, we're back. I know it's not the first time we've done this. What year is it, guys? What year is it, Card? Do you know?
Red.
So that is a great example of how not to negotiate with a hostage. Don't ask them questions where there's a definitive yes and no, where they will definitely get it wrong.
And then what we have here is sometimes you could be put in a trunk and there's going to be corn. What do? Eat it. Duh.
That is actually a hostage I negotiated with. That's not a hostage, a terrorist. This is from 2015. This guy's from Iceland. He's got a lot of experience taking hostages. Card's actually the hostage I negotiated out of this terrorist's hands. Hand? Thumb? Crazy. Next slide.
I put pants on for this? I put pants on for this? No, I didn't. Why did you tell them that, Barb? I'm not wearing pants.
I know you're not. And I've told you so many times. So unprofessional. Corey in the house, he's a professional, you know?
Oh my God. What Corey's teaching you here is that sometimes you just gotta hold the world in your hands.
Or, like we rehearsed, you have to hold the hostage after you've gotten them back to make them know that they're safe.
Oh, yeah, that part.
Nothing like a good hug, you know?
And then once you hug them, it's finger licking good.
Who shouldn't negotiate hostages? Anyone who doesn't work for the CIA. I'm talking to you, FBI.
Good one, Barb.
Okay, you don't have to praise everything I do, Carl. So
sometimes when you're being held hostage, they like to cut up your body into pieces.
and it can get really graphic, and I think we just need to be completely serious and say that. You need to do everything at all costs to make sure that you're safe.
You almost had it. It was really good though. He couldn't get through that. Another really common thing aside from cutting up your body is waterboarding. As you can see right here.
Similar to surfing.
it's not exactly the same. No, that's one way to look at it. All right, next slide.
Our favorite. Do it. Hit it.
Okay. I think it's ramen noodles. You know, we try to spice it up, you know, we're super serious, and now we're fun. Here's the thing about me. I like eating ramen noodles, and my favorite TV show is Orange is the New Black.
And my favorite TV show is Jeopardy.
Which shocks me just as much as it does you.
Okay, and then this is this is what some hostagers might look like. So they may look pretty and like have a good skincare routine, but danger, danger.
Danger. That's what you're talking out of, Carb. You're talking out of an elephant's ass.
A slide.
Yeah, that's what I meant. So suspend your belief, you guys. Suspend your beliefs about hostage negotiation. And take this journey with us for a moment. So this man is actually the head of the world. And he is the best hostage negotiator I've ever met. I've learned everything from him.
That's just Chancellor Boschini on a character from Star Wars. So.
Fuck, man.
Say one big happy
family. That's what you want. After you've gotten all your hostages, you can just
with the person together. That takes you hostage. You want to be a big happy family. Oh my
God. We were all hostages at one point.
Yeah.
We all were.
Yeah. And it's okay. You don't have to be ashamed of it.
We all were hostages of our mother's womb. We're hostages of the world. We're hostages of social distancing. But that's all, folks.
And that's all, Flux.
Thank you guys. Thank you so much.
Well done.
Yeah.
That was a good look for you, Brayden.
Doing good.
Oh boy.
Who?
What's our next game?
My next game is Three-Headed Monster.
Yes. Brenda.
Okay, it's called Three-Headed Monster, and it is for Christian, Allie, and Annabelle. Okay, so let's pretend for this game that it's Christian on one side, that's on the left side, Allie, and then Annabelle. Mm-hmm. That makes sense. Okay, so the way this game works is that we have a monster that's here to answer any of your questions, but they can only say one word at a time because they're joined together as one person, monster. So basically we're just going to get a bunch of questions from you guys and from our Zoom audience. So let's get started with you guys. Who has a question? Yes, you have the glasses.
Yeah, this is Coach Randy. Tweet, go Huskies! I'm having a little bit of trouble getting my boys motivated. And I was wondering if you had any good advice for any motivation in order to get them going for the season.
Well,
I
must
take
a
fart
into
a
bowl.
Okay.
Great, great, thanks. Okay, this question comes from Bailey Cockerham, and she says, how does one do the renegade?
Let.
Me.
Show.
You.
What?
The.
Hell.
I.
Got.
Under.
These.
Masks.
Bitch.
Thank you. I think she knows how to do the renegade now. yes, you and the red beard.
Yeah, I am very afraid of bridges, and I was just wondering if you could help me overcome that fear.
Mm-hmm. Walking
over
the
bridge
is
fun.
Sometimes.
Except
when
your
pants
fall
down.
This question comes from Violet Comer. How do you do surgery on a grape?
Peeling.
A.
Is.
Very.
Sufficient.
Four.
Different.
Surgeries.
But.
I.
Don't.
One last question from you in the yellow.
I've never been to a frat party. How do I act? That's from one of my followers.
Drunk.
And that's the game.
Yay.
Good job.
All right, nice. Moving on to the next one.
Okay, we got a next game for you. And this one's called Poems. And it's for Eric, Nigel, and Christian.
Yay.
Yay. Yay.
How this game works, it's going to be similar to another game we played earlier, Good, Bad, Worst. We're going to have these three people. They're at a poetry slam, and they're going to do some poems. But let me get some suggestions about what the topic for the poems are.
Ooh.
Yeah, you in the yellow. Or just shout them out. Just shout them out.
Oranges.
Allergies.
Healthy cooking.
Peeing in public.
Family reunions over Zoom.
I like family reunions over Zoom. Let's hear some poems about family reunions over Zoom. And we'll start with Eric and then go to Nigel and then to Christian.
Is this thing on? Kiddos hear me?
Yep, all right. Yep. Yeah, we're hearing
My name is Mr. Crothers, and my grandkids told me I need to express myself more, so I came out here. Hello? To do some poetry for the kiddos. This is a poem I wrote. It's about family reunions that are more and more important to me as I near death. Cousin, nephew, uncle, aunt. I hate my grandchildren, the miscreant. Always coming over to my house, eating snacks, leaving louse. Oh, baking cookies, cooking pies, whisking eggs. They don't say goodbye. Christmas takes about 7 years, and all it brings is Christmas tears. Ho, 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 say no, no, no. I'm Mr. Crothers, and the family's got to go, go, go. Thank you. Did you get that? If you, yeah. It's good.
Okay, next we'll have this gentleman in the white hat go.
Oh, I'm sorry you had to see me pop and lock. I just had to show you what Uncle Tony's got. In my hips, you surely will see all the magic to the family reunion I will bring. Because I know when you're out there grilling on the stove, you don't know and you don't want to see how I heave and hoe. Because on this Zoom, I know it's electronic, but really, feel it inside. You'll want to pop and lock it.
No, no.
And that's Uncle Tony for you.
Next in the black.
My name is Derek. I'm 17 years old. Been quarantined for a month and a half. Pretty over this bullshit. My counselor suggested I write a poem to express how I'm feeling. So here it goes. Helping grandma with her iPad, teaching mom how to unmute dad. 2 months of this shit already over. I want to throw my body onto the stove. When is quarantine going to end? I miss all of my improv friends. Help me, please. I can't take it anymore. I really just want to walk out that fucking door. Thank you. Thank you.
And that's the game.
Yeah.
Wow. Yay. Okay, Ryan's hosting this, but yeah. Our last game. And before you do host it, we didn't talk about this before. We will all, once we're out, we can find a very dramatic way to end our video like that. So that'll be when you're out of the game.
Oh, yeah.
You'll stay in the meeting, right?
What?
You'll stay in the meeting, but like.
Yes.
Stay in the meeting. Stay in the meeting, but end your, stop your video. Somehow, like a fun, sexy time, you know? Like a, like ABC Die type of deal, but with this. Okay. Sorry. Thank you.
Okay.
Hey guys, this is our last game, but before that, if you guys are interested in what we're doing, come and do some loose ends with us Tuesdays on Tom Brown P. Wright Commons. It's open to anyone. It's a fun time. Come hang out with us. All that,
yeah, guys. Back.
Don't forget to follow us on Instagram and Twitter.
Fill out your spots unless they closed.
Ooh, fill out your spots for that $50 Amazon gift card. You're definitely not going to win. Woo!
All right. Let's get into it.
Cool. So the last game that we have for everyone is called Roo-Roo-Roo. And the way this game works is that everyone in SAC is going to be given a category and they are going to have to list off things in that category that could exist but don't. So say, for example, your category is Harry Potter books. If you say Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, that would be wrong because that already exists. But if you say Harry Potter and the Chamber of an Unreasonable Number of Snakes, that would be just fine because it could exist but does not. So, I already wrote down a list of things. So I guess once you have your thing, just try to remember it. No, I don't have a list of categories. I just have a list of names because we normally have one up there. Christian, or give, start yelling at and I'll assign them to people.
Chili's menu items.
What?
All right.
Chili's menu items.
Ice cream flavors.
People have said that three times. So, Aaron, you want Chili's menu items?
Me?
Yeah, you got it.
Yeah.
Aaron has Chili's menu items.
Ice cream flavors.
Okay.
Hand sanitizer scents.
Zodiac signs and dominant traits.
Yoga poses. All right.
Annabelle, yours is hand sanitizer scents.
Oh, yoga poses is a good one.
Allie, science, yours is yoga poses.
Oh, horoscopes.
Zodiac signs and their dominant traits.
Huh. Enneagrams.
Porno titles.
Types dinosaur. Of bread that aren't like banana bread, but not banana bread.
Movie genre.
Pinterest recipes.
I like Enneagrams.
Types of rooms.
Brayden, you get Enneagrams.
Fuck yeah.
Can Aaron's be types of rooms?
Aaron's is already Chili's menu item.
Ooh, pizza toppings.
Oh, Friends episodes.
Yeah. Hannah, you get that one.
That's so good.
Ways to tie a scarf.
Oh, alternatives to glasses. How many
different ways there are.
Teletubbies.
Alternatives to glasses.
All right. Types
of music.
Teletubbies.
Ska bands.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Keaton, you want Teletubbies?
Yeah.
White Claw flavors.
How about I make it look like flavors and give it to two?
Cocktails.
Children's fairy tales.
Oh, B movie titles.
Cocktails.
Children's fairy tales.
I'll do it.
Hell yeah.
I'm just now realizing I don't know anything about Teletubbies.
Welcome to the
Ryan, you should just type them in the chat as a list.
I could do that. That could have been a thing I've been doing.
Sorry, I just thought.
All right.
Come on, Ryan.
Wait, can I actually do it?
Writing
plots?
No, you don't have Teletubbies. You get to
learn. I don't know anything about Teletubbies.
Wait, what were you saying? What were you
Improv.
Saying?
Glee plots, like plots from the show Glee.
Oh my gosh.
Outrageous.
I need a category for Christian, John, and Nigel.
I don't know. What's my category?
Chris is the Croy flavors.
Okay,
I guess we'll tell W's. Okay, we're gonna make this work.
Modes of transportation.
Okay.
Read.
Historical figures. In the Boston Tea Party events, things that happened, things that were going on during the Boston Tea Party, but weren't actually the Boston Tea Party.
Our worst planets.
What did you say, Christian?
Our worst planets.
Yeah, you get that one.
Oh, that's good.
That's a good one.
National anthems.
Avengers. Nigel, you get national anthems.
National anthems. Okay.
Olympic events.
Give me and Avengers.
John, you get Olympic events.
Ah!
Ooh,
Avengers. I'll do Olympic events, actually.
Wait, type them out.
Okay, what else? So.
I got it. That's mine.
Amazing.
Incredible. All right, I think that's all of them.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Just for the audience at home that can't see the chat, Aaron has Chili's menu items. Annabelle has hand sanitizer scents. Allie has yoga poses. Brayden has Enneagrams. Hannah has Friends episodes. Keaton has Teletubbies. Eric has children's fairy tales. Taylor has LaCroix flavors, Christian has Star Wars planets, John has Olympic events, and Nigel has national anthems. Let's kick this off. Aaron? Yes.
Okay. Corn on the floor. It's like corn on the cob, but your waiter spilled it, and now they're going to get fired, but you kind of feel bad for them, so you're going to just lick that shit up.
Incredible. I love it. Nigel?
My first thing I want to do is take God Save the Queen, but change it for England, and so that it's please God let her outlive Betty White.
Good. Love it. Brayden?
Type 10, and your main personality trait is that you're the girlfriend that feels the need to say his boy or her boyfriend's full name in front of his friends.
Love it. Awesome. Taylor?
2-day-old used tea bag.
Incredible. Taylor? No, not Taylor. Christian?
Chun Taun. It's, they make ice cream and butter from blue milk.
Awesome. Allie?
Another Zoom meeting.
Nice. Eric.
Little Rainbow Riding Hood. Instead of a red hood, it can be any color, and it's like a mood ring, and it shows what she's feeling at the time.
Okay. John.
The Chili Chase. It's like a relay race, but instead of a baton, it's a bowl of chili that everyone has to eat and finish by the end of the race.
That's disgusting. I love it. Hannah.
The one where Phoebe loses all of her rings that she wears in like every episode.
Nice. Annabelle?
There's a national shortage. You'll take whatever the fuck you can get.
Incredible. Keaton?
Shitsy. The shape on her head is the poop emoji.
Awesome. John.
Oh, the deeper dive. It's instead of diving into a pool, it's just a lot of mayonnaise.
No.
I have been eliminated.
We can still hear you, John. Allie.
Insomnia.
Nice. Eric.
Eric or Aaron?
E-R-I-C.
Okay. Hansel and Pretzel. It's the classic story, but instead of the moral being don't trust witches, callback, it's the moral of the story is there's a dangerous amount of sodium in the world.
Cool. Brave.
The I'm Downest. See John Badar for reference.
Nice. Awesome. Nigel.
It's a new one I'm working on, but it's basically for North Korea because it's going to be when Kim Jong-un is finally announced that he's dead because we all know that it's real. He's dead. Ooh. We're just waiting.
Ooh, relevant. Nice. Hannah?
The one where Phoebe reveals that when she was 12, she was the leader of a cult. And they're still existing.
Episode eliminated.
What? What? No, eliminated. I should never be eliminated. This is, I'm, whatever. John, do you hear me?
John, I'm with you.
Pick up my call, John.
We can hear you both.
Anna, shut up.
Ryan is so annoying.
Anna, don't get me started on Ryan, okay? Don't get me started.
It's like, he thinks he's just like in charge of everything and like just because he has the power to like eliminate us, then that we can like, it's like, beep, it's like not fair, you know? It's like, I can do what I want, you know?
We're good? Cool. Nice. Taylor?
Steamed vegetable water. It's the water after you steam the vegetables that's left.
Disgusting. Love it. Aaron?
Chili's signature lobster. A lobster so red and so hot, it'll leave you wondering, has Chili's always had lobster? And should I trust it?
Sure, Annabelle.
Raging butthole for when this whole thing is over, but you're feeling a little bit nostalgic.
Yep.
Oh,
like half of these things, like I totally should have stayed in, you know? I hear half of these things and it's like, mine was better. Mine was better. I should have.
Muter.
Mute. Oh, so this is heckler now.
Tipsy. He's a lot like Lala, except his favorite White Claw flavor is mango.
I'm almost 100% sure Tipsy is actually one of the Teletubbies.
No way. I don't think so.
Tipsy. Tinky Winky.
It's
Tipsy,
true.
Winky, Lala, Oopsie.
Poke.
The man Sun Baby.
Cut him.
Lala, Po.
Too bad I've already eliminated you.
Ha ha, got him!
Nigel, go.
It's a new one for New Zealand. It's called I'm Still Here, and it's the tune of Frere Jacques.
Cool. Braden.
The Credit Seeker. Just kidding. That's a type one.
Nice. Damn. Christian.
It's Mono Thway. It's where all those Jedi younglings that Anakin supposedly murdered went.
My God. Aaron.
So it's really shitty food, and it's all from that falafel place that Hannah made us go to in Chicago, but they put it on the Chili's menu now.
I like that falafel place. Eliminated.
Thank you.
Eric.
Tinderella. It's kind of like Cinderella, but there's Tinder, and it's bippity boppity boo.
Okay, Annabelle.
Social distance salami. You won't need help staying 6 feet apart from other people. I'm gonna
eliminate you for that one.
Did you,
Taylor.
Seattle Fish Market. It's the melted ice that the fish sit on.
Disgusting. Allie. John, you're back.
Disgusting.
Connection.
Nice. Nigel.
We just finally let one of the songs from Hunchback be the national anthem of Notre Dame.
Work. Notre Dame is not a country. Eliminated.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm just going to get myself set up here. I didn't really know how to disconnect, but I've been trying some new things. I don't know if this works.
Just turn your video off.
The type 525,600, it's just a sad theater major.
Nice. Awesome. Taylor?
Seawater from the Dead Sea, so it's just extra salty.
I'm going to say no. Goodbye, Taylor.
Die.
All right, Christian.
Fandalore, it's where all Star Wars super fans exist.
No.
Fuck you.
Eliminated.
Worth it.
The final three.
Goodbye, Batman. Eric.
Little Miss Tuffet sat on a piece of IKEA furniture. And what that is, it's a beautiful fairy tale of how consumerism was destroyed by multi-conglomerate companies.
Boy howdy, that sounds depressing. Eliminated.
Yeah, but like, and hear me out on this one. You might want to read that book someday.
Eliminated.
Also, it might not just laugh. It might, in fact, be... Oh, that was weird. Did it work? Is this working? Did I do this?
Allie, your turn.
Day 37 of quarantine.
Nice. Braden.
The type 12, the clapper. It's the old middle-aged white men that clap when the plane lands.
Oh.
Nice. Allie.
So John Vader.
Toilet paper.
Nice. Braden.
The type 13. It's just Hannah Baker.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Am I eliminated?
No.
Why?
What the hell?
Allie?
Oh, sorry. Motivation. Where?
Unless Braden can't do one right now. You are eliminated. Braden.
The type 15, it's the people that say you too when the waiter tells you to have a nice meal.
And Braden wins.
Hey.
Oh god.
Amazing. Wow.
Well done.
Done.
Everyone hold hands.
The show.
Sure.
Everyone hold hands. Wait, everyone.
Thank you. We are Senseless Acts of Comedy.